So the next organization that I want to talk about is an organization that I work with as a consultant. So that's my disclaimer. I was working there as the communications consultant initially, and right now as the social media consultant and manager. So this is organization is called the Association of People with Disability, more commonly known as APD. So if CRY India was an old organization at starting from 1979, this organization is a legacy because it started in 1959. So it's been there a long time and very much grown, and it has grown, very, very organically. So the person who started this was NS Hema. She and a group of another people with disability and without disability started this because there was this huge gap where nobody, neither government nor private organizations, were really doing anything to address the needs of people with disability in the lower income groups specifically. Because even the people in the larger income groups really didn't have a lot of options available to them, but at least because of their money, they were cushioned from a lot of discomforts. Whereas the people who were in the lower income group, people with disability, would, mostly end up begging on the streets. And that was a terrible future, which NS Hema, the founder, saw. And she decided that, it's more, rather than just giving money, it's important to improve the capacity of these people so that they can earn their money and lead an independent and dignified life, which was a wonderful way to get started. And that is what they did. They started from industrial training to, gradually moving on to BPO training and horticulture training, and today they have about 7-8 skills that they train people on, apart from which they also offer a number of rehabilitation services for people with disability. So I wanted to talk about my experience there and how we actually set up the whole marketing thing. When I was called in, there wasn't much that they were doing on the digital front. They did have their social media pages and they were sending out emails once in a while, but there wasn't a very clear-cut strategy. So when I came in, the marketing director at that time, really helped me understand how things were. And what I recognized was that one of the biggest challenges which I saw in that organization was that, there was a huge lack of understanding of the digital market. Completely. There were just a few people who understood it and wanted to bring that element in. Being an organization that started in 1959, there were a lot of people there who were working from, 25, 30 years, who were also very comfortable working in a certain way. And bringing in that digital kind of mindset was going to take a little time. So that was one of the challenges. Then the other thing was there was a lack of expertise. Even the people who were in the marketing team lacked that expertise to work on the digital front. They were very good with, face-to-face event management, calling and talking to people on the phone and, attending to the walk-ins and showing them around. And, and because the work itself was so authentic and so impactful that anybody who came into the organization or came in touch with the organization would want to, join the organization either as a volunteer or to, donate to the cause, because the work was really very transformative. Just walking into that organization actually changed me personally as well, because it was a place with so much positivity and people all around having different forms of disability, so positive and, engaging in regular activities, talking to each other in sign language. The whole atmosphere was so different from that conventional corporate kind of thing I was used to. It was a life-changing experience for me as well. So I saw that and I experienced that the very first day that, that genuine work is being done here, but it is just not being promoted in the way it should be on the digital front. The other thing was a lack of resources, because the team obviously did not have that kind of digital expertise to support this. And of course, the budgets, which are always an issue with nonprofits. And though this was a much larger nonprofit, even then, the budgetary aspect was something which had to be considered. The goal when we started with the digital marketing to, you know, have a communication strategy in place, to have a marketing strategy in place, was largely to raise funds and to create awareness, because APD was, though a very respected organization, was known more in the nonprofit circles. And because it was specifically serving, it's not a national organization. It is serving people in Karnataka and a few neighboring areas in Tamil Nadu and Andhra. Beyond that, the recognition was a little low. There was, of course, niche pockets within which it was known, because it was one of the few organizations in the area of disability. But however, it was understood that it was recognized that we were not able to grow the donor base beyond a certain area, because there was a huge lack of awareness about the work this organization is doing. So it was very important to increase the reach through the digital mediums. So how did they resolve it? One was, of course, the very starting point where, you know, they hired a digital marketing expert as a consultant, which is me here. But the fact that, you know, even recognizing that that kind of expertise is not available in your organization, and you now need to reach out and be willing to, you know, pay somebody to help you out here. That's a great first step. It is a very important first step, because many organizations don't take that first step at all and still continue to try to manage on their own and then stay on that kind of path for years without really seeing any outcome. Then they also had this inflow of content which used to come from you know, the people who were working on the ground through a WhatsApp chat. So everything that was being done used to come there, you know, with pictures and videos and descriptions, but mining that, you know, and getting meaningful information out of it, checking for permissions, and, you know, keeping in mind things like the sensitivity of the information, privacy concerns, and especially if there are children concerned, you know, making sure there are permissions, or, you know, sometimes not using the face of the child. All those things were things that had to be, you know, thought about, because now you're going on the digital medium. There are so many risks that also go up. You also become open to a lot of criticism, right? So all those things had to be considered. Then APD also got the marketing team trained on digital marketing, which was a very good step, because it helped them ramp up on certain systems and technology, which were very helpful to them, which really reduced the amount of time they were spending on, you know, on their own communications with other team members across departments and all of that. And also how they could, run, say, an email marketing program. So initially they were running the email marketing program by sending out bulk emails using their personal accounts. And then they shifted to MailChimp, which allowed them to structure their emails better, to segment their audience better, to get a better handle on the analytics, to really understand it. Because till now they were saying, like, you know, the way the email campaign was judged was based on the number of donations it raised. Apart from that, there were no other analytics when you're just sending it out through your Gmail account, right? So with analytics, with email MailChimp coming in, you could see what was the open rate, how many emails were actually bouncing, which showed us that a lot of the data in the database was not even accurate. You know, it had to be cleaned up. So these are very important insights which come in when you move into the digital aspect, because the trackability element becomes so much more precise. Then developing the campaigns in collaboration with the CEO and the marketing head and the other members of the team was very useful, because it made sure that everything that you were doing in the marketing team, or, you know, in the digital marketing space, was aligned with the business priorities at that time, which is so very important, right? Because if you want to if you want to do a certain thing, it's important that it is in alignment with the larger objective. Right. And it also helped in developing a very good marketing calendar, because we would also know certain events that would be happening in, let's say, the next 1 or 2 months for which we could proactively create content and, you know, get the stuff ready. So a lot of last minute disruptions were also removed. Some delays which used to happen because, you know, something you just get to know a day before, those kind of things were removed. Some kind of discipline was brought into that process. I wouldn't say 100%. That's very difficult because a nonprofit atmosphere is very similar to a startup. And because there are a lot of people involved and, you know, you get directions from a lot of different areas. So it's a little difficult to bring that to that 100% stage. But even if you bring it down, if you can reduce the confusion and the chaos to somewhere around 60%, it's still good. Then running different kinds of social media campaigns with multiple objectives. We did a lot of experimentation with the creatives, with the way we want to run campaigns. We did both paid as well as organic campaigns and, you know, understood what was not working in the paid campaigns, why it was not working. Also recognizing where we needed some creative agency to, you know, give us some inputs because, even identifying the gaps. Where were the skill gaps in the team? That creative aspect was something which was, you know, required. So that was a great exercise. Then we started with the email marketing campaign, sending out general information through emails as well as appeals. And very lately, we started an email newsletter. Till now, they had this quarterly newsletter which was going out, which would be like a PDF attachment. And, you know, I had been talking to them since a long time that you have to shift to the email newsletter mode. Because that is far more impactful and, you know, people can just get the information directly as soon as they open the email versus, you know, having to click on something, then it opens up as a PDF, which takes time. And a PDF is not very easy to read on an email, on a mobile platform, for one thing. So this also really helped. They actually got very good response from the donors, from the people they were connected with. On this, and it also led to a lot of donations coming in. So that really worked out well. Then also they came up with an alternative donation page layout. So the donors, since they are offering so many services, somewhere around 8 to 9, you know, services within the disability space, the donation page had a lot of options for people. You know, you could donate for wheelchairs, you could donate for meals for schools, you could donate for meals for horticulture trainees, you could donate for livelihood courses. There were a lot of such options, and it was always a debate, you know, whether it is too confusing. So they created an alternative which had a simpler kind of layout and, you know, that kind of testing happened, which is a great way to find out what really works. Then integrating the modern payment methods, the wallets and all of that, the UPI into the website was another way in which we encouraged people to donate more easily. Then also in the offline events, using a QR code in your in the banner and all of that helped because people would just scan and, you know, immediately get to the donation page and make the payments. Doing consistent blogging, using Google Ad Grants, working on the SEO aspects of the content on the website, not just on the website, but even on social media, everywhere, wherever information was public, the SEO aspect was something which you always kept in mind. Then also taking advantage of the existing crowdsourcing platforms, the Impact Guru, Keto, Global Giving, Give India, sending out campaigns there, which also contribute some contributions do come from there. Collaborating with various organizations, other organizations like Dana Mojo, Donate Card, Paytm. That is also now another source of, you know, donations. And also a lot of webinars in the last year, which has led to a significant improvement in the reach. A lot of the webinars were on extremely important topics on healthcare for people with disability, especially during the pandemic, when they could not go to hospitals and rehabilitation centers to receive the therapy, which is extremely critical for them. So because, you know, that the mobility and all of that are such important aspects which can really take their condition, you know, down the road, how important it is. So, you know, a lot of webinars were conducted on those kind of issues and how parents can help do these things for their children and what they need to take care of, what warning signs they need to be aware of. A lot of such webinars were conducted in that pandemic time, which did extremely well and helped APD really reach a wide audience across the world, not just the country. As a result of all these things which were done, fundraising definitely picked up. Online fundraising definitely picked up. There was much higher reach and awareness. In fact, there was a post, Twitter post from John Abraham, who talked about how important it is that people with disability are not left behind. And he tagged APD India as one of the organizations that, you know, support our friends, which really helped increase the reach during that time. And even now, it's been like 7-8 months since that happened. Even now, that tweet is getting retweeted, and you know, APD is continuing to get the advantage of that amplified messaging. And then there are on our social media pages, we get inquiries from across the country today on the services and on the jobs and how people can get help, legal help, and different forms of help. And then there are partnership inquiries coming in from across the country. So this has become, so the social media has really become a source of, opportunities for the organization to grow its partnerships. And there is also international reach, especially happening on Twitter, which is really helping. There are organizations, disability organizations across the